Hey, how you doing? I'm just looking through the folder where we keep some of the old Ekko programs, trying to find something that you might like. Here's one from May 10th, 2013, with the great anchor Johanna Neen. If I recall right, this particular episode included another package or story from the Industrial Tech Pod. We like to head down there once a semester. They've always got something cool going on. And it also includes a story on lookalikes. Anybody ever hear of Walter White? From May 10th, 2013, here's the Ekko. Cue the logo.
Today we'll hear about Mother's Day plans, play some instruments, and meet some people you might believe look like some other people. All of this and so much more is next on The Ekko. Hastings High School. Today is Friday, the 10th of May, 2013. I'm Johanna Neen for The Ekko. We begin this week's show tracking a sport. But what does a track team with a snow-covered track do? Well, practice, of course. Over the hurdles and through the rain, this track team is gone. But all of their hard work is paying off. The Hastings High School boys track and field team has been training since spring break, and in some cases before for this season. Even without Mother Nature on their side, they've managed to pull together and even get some hardware.
Winning the Richfield invite was really exciting. It was really nice to have the kids just go out, compete hard, and to realize that track isn't just about getting first places, because we had a lot of kids that did really well in their events, didn't maybe win, but scored some points for the team, and ultimately in the end that means winning as a team.
So a good amount of this success must be attributed to the head boys coach, Jason Cook. He finds that coaching track is quite different than any other sport. Nevertheless, he is devoted to his boys on and off the track. He has high hopes for their future individually and as a team. While great distances are covered by many on the track team, the same can also be said for another group of students at our school. Their love, however, is not in foot power, it's in horsepower. Do you love cars? Well, then you better listen up as the Ekko's Morgan Quist drives you into a great story.
Everyone has experience being in a car, or even driving one. But have you ever thought about what exactly goes into making one? A few of our students have been putting in a lot of hard work after school to build what they call a high-mileage vehicle. Since last fall, they have been working on it twice a week with our very own Mr. Dietz.
We did it because a lot of other high schools in Minnesota does it. It's a good chance for the kids to have to design and build a car that gets good mileage. There's a lot of problem-solving, engineering, that kind of stuff, where they actually have to build it as well as design it.
The students that work on this car are what you can call a team. Yes, at times, it can be challenging, but they work hard for an awesome outcome.
It's a lot of fun. You get to work on the car and drive it around a lot, which is fun, too.
Do you think you're interested in this for next year? Don't be afraid to try it out.
We have a very wide cross-section of kids. We have some kids that are in lots of industrial tech classes, some kids that have never been in an industrial tech class. So basically any kid that is interested is more than welcome to be part of it.
At times, it can be somewhat dangerous.
Whenever we're working with things, sometimes sparks fly, or even when we're doing the exterior of the car, we're paper mache, we try to keep stuff out of our eyes.
Their masterpiece isn't quite finished yet, but you can sure stop down and check it out. I'm Morgan Quist, reporting for The Ekko.
Thanks, Morgan. That car sounds like a great way to save money. And with that extra money, you could spend it on a ticket to hear some great music. This coming Monday, May 13th, is a night you might want to clear your calendar. It's the night of the very last band concert of the 2012-2013 school year. On top of outstanding music, this will also be a final performance for many of the band's seniors. One trumpet player in particular expressed to us how sad he will be when this year is over.
I'm gonna miss band a lot. It's a really big, happy family. We all are really close friends in the band, and the music selection is just awesome to play.
Band has not just been a class for Dan. With memories and life lessons, we know the wonderful directors here at HHS have given these seniors the tools to go out in the world, whether it be making music or pursuing something else. Good luck to our band next Monday. There's another fine group of folks who keep the school humming along ever so smoothly, day in and day out. You've seen them around, you've met them, but do you really know them? The Ekko's Ryan Saxton caught up with these fine people we call the secretaries.
For some of us, we are just starting out here at Hastings High School. For others, it's going to be time to leave. However, there are a few fine women in this building that will be here for hopefully a long, long time. We like to call them secretaries. We have a few offices with secretaries in our building. The attendance office with Mrs. Fryermuth and Mrs. Castle, the counseling office with Mrs. Schlander and Mrs. Andrews, the student office with Mrs. McDougall, and the main office with Mrs. Besko and Mrs. Penrod. All of our secretaries got started here, but the question is, how long ago?
Probably 16 years.
3 years in February.
15 years in this position for.
I started in the spring of 2010.
This is my fifth year.
I've been here about 12 years.
I've been here for 23.
Each of these ladies has a different backstory as to how they got started here at Hastings High School.
I just wanted to get a job while my kids were in school, and so I started subbing in the district.
And I started as a sub and then was hired on full-time.
I transferred over from the kindergarten center before it closed.
I used to work for community ed, doing bookkeeping there, but I really like the idea of just working during the school year, so I applied for this job and got it.
In addition, each secretary enjoys working here for their own specific reason.
Just enjoy working with the students.
Always something different to do.
I love interacting with the kids and the parents.
I like the variety. You see adults, you see kids, you see everybody. I like that.
I love the people that I work with. The principals are great. The nurses, the outer office staff, everyone here is really super.
And the high school's a fun place to work.
Many of you may think that being a secretary means just answering phones and making appointments. But the reality is, there's a lot more than that.
I don't get summers off. People think I'm off in the summer, and people think we're off when the kids are off, which is not true. We're usually here.
I don't think people know that I do all the data. I think they see me and I make appointments and I take phone calls, but I don't know that they know all the data side of it, that I do the reports and the grading and all that.
Some of these offices in our building have student aides that assist them in their daily work.
I like working with them because they're fun people and they keep everything interesting.
So whether you are a student or staff in the building, be sure to stop by these offices and thank the secretaries for all their hard work. Reporting for the Ekko, I'm Ryan Saxton.
Thanks, Ryan. Hey, if you need an appointment, a pass, or just someone to talk to, stop by any of their offices and say hello. Someone else you might want to share a smile with is your mom, especially this coming Sunday. What's so special about this Sunday, you ask? Well, if you don't know, then you're already one step behind. It's Mother's Day. We caught up with a few of our very own students to hear about their plans for the holiday.
I'll probably buy her some flowers and tell her how much I love her.
I'm going to try to make her a cake and get her a good card.
I'm going to get her a coffee at Dunn Brothers, buy her flowers, and make her breakfast.
I'm going to write my mom a poem for Mother's Day.
We're going to clean for her and go out to eat.
I don't really know. I'll think of something.
I would love 3 good kids and a really clean house.
So Craig, you better get the vacuum fired up. But in the meantime, think for a second. Have you ever walked by someone in the halls and thought, they look just like a celebrity, or maybe even a teacher? The Ekko's Jake Bullington takes a look at who's who.
It is said that there are 7 people in the world that look exactly like you. Are one of those 7 people walking in the same halls as you are? Celebrities, athletes, and sometimes even our own faculty, Hastings has a few doppelgangers that stand out from the rest. Take freshman Ken Cartwright, for example. Ken is said to be the spitting image of Mr. McClay.
We both like sports and Clash of Clans, so.
Mr. Veit, an assistant principal here at HHS, could be cast as Walter White on the popular television show Breaking Bad.
I think it was more a matter of Walter White was starting to look like me,
when he gave me a call and he wanted to share the look that I had. And so that's when he made his move.
Junior Maria Knoll might as well be dating Robert Patterson as a total lookalike of Kristen Stewart.
I don't get offended or anything, but I don't take it as a compliment either.
And Carter Nelson is said to look like comedian Daniel Tosh.
Well, I'm a lot funnier. Maybe the hair.
Mr. Willett has a reputation of being compared to a celebrity as well. Bob Saget, a star of the sitcom Full House, looks exactly like this faculty member.
I never really did, but I've been hearing it every year since I've been teaching, so I'm come around, I'm convinced. Yes, I am a dead ringer for Bob Saget. I'm a family of five, I got three little kids, so yeah, Danny Tanner, you know, is looking more and more like me every day, you know, as my kids grow older, and yeah, my life is turning into Full House.
Mr. Willett would even consider being a Bob Saget impersonator if it wasn't for being a teacher.
That's a wonderful idea. I wonder if there's a big market out there for it. If there is, I think I'll look into it.
And one of the most well-known lookalikes in our school, Mrs. Jagger, is someone we could have all sworn we've seen on TV. Of who? The Sundrop Girl, of course.
Sundrop, and show us how you drop it.
Because I got it going on.
And I was shocked because, yes, she does. The woman looks a lot like me. In fact, I went home and showed the video to my son, and he was probably about six at the time, and he thought it was me. In a previous life of mine, I did a lot of dancing. I danced all the way through high school, and in college I was on the dance team, and I dance around my house, and I make big faces when I dance.
Mrs. Jagger has been getting an earful from students about it, and even shares a few more similarities with a comical role portrayed in the Sundrop commercials. If you happen to see any of these students or staff in the hallways, make sure to say hello. They may even point out who you look like to them. Reporting for The Ekko, I'm Jake Bullington.
Wow, thanks Jake. Keep an eye out for similar-looking students and staff. Speaking of staff, there's one member of HHS that's been working very hard on a special event coming up. But he hasn't been working alone. Tuesday, April 23rd was the first day of ticket sales, and it was anything but low-key. We asked how ticket sales this year are compared to years past.
I think this year, well, we're over 200 couples at this point, which is really quite a few. We usually have about 250 to 260 couples, so we're definitely on our way to having a good crowd this year.
What do you have to say to those who are on the fence about buying prom tickets?
I say you should definitely buy tickets because prom is hopefully going to be really awesome this year, and it's a once-in-a-lifetime chance, so go buy tickets.
Prom is coming up next week, and HHS recognizes that day with a whole week of activities, including dress-up days. Monday is Pajama Day, Tuesday is Ninja Day, Wednesday is America Day, Thursday is Workout Day, and Friday is College Apparel Day. For the past 10 years, the Ekko has celebrated prom by dedicating an entire show to the event, and that show is next Thursday. You don't want to miss it. Until then, I'm Johanna Neen, and thanks for stopping by on The Ekko. I look so deep in your eyes.